Russia currently maintains two lines of 4++ generation fighters, the Mig-35 and the Su-35, which are controversial among Russian military experts. According to Russian media, the Mig-35S fighters, belonging to the first mass production batch, have completed all tests and entered service ahead of schedule. But why does Russia need another 4++ generation fighter when it already has the Su-35S? And will Mig-35S become a competitor of the Su-35S? The Mig-35, similar to the Su-35, are all 4++ generation fighters. The Mig-35 is an advanced development of the Mig-29. This is the version that deserves to be considered the best of the Fulcrum family. It should be noted that the Mig-35 still retains the lightness of its predecessor, but significantly faster, with 1,400 km per hour at low altitude and 4,400 km per hour at 7,500 meters altitude. The Mig-35S is equipped with modern avionics systems, integrated electronic warfare equipment, and 10 hardpoints. The fighter possesses super maneuverability, powered by three-dimensional thrust vector engines. The Mig-35 is considered the world's best multi-role fighter for all missions. The Su-35, known as the elite Sukhoi 4++ generation fighter, is also a super maneuverable aircraft. The single seat and two engine aircraft is a derivative of the famous Su-27 heavy fighter. While both the fighter jets, the Mig-35 and the Su-35, deploy similar technologies, the two are different in their fundamental designs. Although an assessment of their capabilities and key differences can provide insight into the nature of both programs and their possible futures. According to Russian military experts, the heavy flanker is needed to escort long-range bombers to attack strategic locations deep in enemy territory, as well as to break through fortified air defense areas. In turn, the purpose of fighters like the Mig-35S is to deploy it closer to the front lines. On the other hand, the Mig-35 is the most preferred fighter to carry out air combats, aerial reconnaissance, striking surface targets, and providing support to troops and forces at land. The Su-35 is designed with intent and mission to gain air superiority, thereby capable of spotting and destroying targets at air and ground. With the help of Irbis E-radar, the range of detection is over 400 km and can damage up to 30 airborne targets simultaneously. The Mig-35 employs the first active electronically scanned array radar, EASA, which is more sophisticated and lighter than Airbus E. Despite this, the Su-35 is preferred as it has an edge over Mig-35 in situational awareness. The export potential of the Mig-35S is enormous, with its asking price of only $45 million. By comparison, the F-16 with a similar configuration, the FA-18 Super Hornet, Eurofighter Typhoon, and the Dassault Rafale will cost $68, $75, $120, and $130 million each, respectively. Though the Su-35 and the Mig-35 share similar designs and technologies, they are intended for different roles. Each of them has an advantage over the other in their respective role. The Su-35, being a higher-end platform, is better equipped to be deployed against elite heavyweights such as F-22 Raptors, while Mig-35 can still hold its ground against even higher-end adversaries and also retaining considerable performance advantages. Although the Mig-35 is very good, according to many independent military experts, this aircraft also has its disadvantages. The hourly cost of the Mig-35 is not cheap, while the technical performance stats are inferior to the Sukhoi heavy fighter. What Mig-35 can do, Su-35 can also, while there is no opposite situation. The low cost of the Mig-35 compared to the Western fighters is also explained by its lower airframe durability. Furthermore, the maintenance costs of the Mig-35, especially for the engines, are extremely expensive. In fact, the Russian Air Force itself still prefers the Su-35, not the Mig-35. It is said that they only agreed to buy the Mig-35 in limited quantities for the main purpose of supporting the manufacturer. My video about Russian Mig-35S ends here. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.